Hello, you all. You already know what we finna get into. We finna get into these messages and see what our Elohim would like us to know at this time. Okay, so y'all. Just shuffling. Somebody been working on they self. So we got a we have a Queen of Wands that could have been working on they self. This person could be an Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, a Virgo, a Scorpio, or a Cancer. But they've been putting in work and working on they self. They have accepted the challenge to work on themselves because of spiritual guidance here and some communication that they receive. Maybe they receive some communication that if they don't change their ways and transform, that they may end up passing away. And they took the information that they got seriously. Listen, because this person, they used to do magic up under the moon. They used to do magic and be really deceptive and do deceptive things to people. But now they're walking away from that and walking towards truth, which is beautiful. So this person is getting their own fulfillment in life and getting a victory. So new life. And this person is even leaving a King of Wands, a masculine, out in the cold. You know, so this person is coming all around. This in expanding. See, this person is expanding beyond illusions. So this person is giving back to themselves. Okay, and this is a tower for a King of Pentacles energy here, because this person is getting justice, seeing the truth about betrayal. And this Queen of Wands has learned something, because I've seen the Three of Pentacles and the, hold on y'all, it was the Three of Pentacles and the Sun. So this Queen of Wands has learned something, right? And now they are healing and, you know, shining and renewing their faith and laying a different foundation. So now the divine is giving them a gift, and with the Knight of Pentacles, it's been a long time coming. Yeah, this person surrendered. Okay. That's what I like to see. Shoot. That's what I like to see. Y'all know I be... And I don't want nobody to feel like, oh, dang, she be... It could be an Aquarius, too. I don't want nobody to feel like, dang, she be super harsh, or she be this, or she be that. No. Sometimes I am super nice and da, 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 but then sometimes y'all might see me going in. But that's because I care. Shoot. And this is what I like to see. I know this is a continuance. I know it is. Somebody didn't probably listen to something that I said, because the Queen of Wands was coming across my table a lot. And I'm happy that, you know, whoever this is has decided to, you know, get justice in their life. Okay? Even if this person been betraying other people and trying to have other people at a dead end, this is about learning. And now this person is taking a risk and wants forgiveness. You know what I'm saying? So it's a beautiful thing, even when people do messed up things, you know, everybody has. Everybody needs saving. Everybody needs forgiveness from Yahshua for something. And if somebody try to tell you otherwise, I'll show you a motherfucking liar. They lying. But this is what it's about. So I'm thankful. So this person could be thinking about letting the leader lead their life and getting justice and support. A new foundation. A metamorphosis. Yep, walking away towards truth and happiness. I know that's right. Escaping the bull crap. escaping the bull crap. I know that's right. That's what it's about. Growth. Growth, honey. Growth. So this person went from being somebody's enemy and stabbing them in the back and causing heartbreak and loss and trauma to setting a new course. To setting a new course. This person was doing this to get opportunities here for a long time. This is what this person would do. They'd do magic and shit and do stuff against people to get things and opportunities and to even slow other people down. This person could have been trying to slow down somebody's Ace of Pentacles. And now this person is turning over a new leaf. You know, I'm a fuss with you. I'm a fuss with you. This person, the reason why this person turning over a new leaf is because they was burdened by the truth. Burdened by the truth. But the truth has caused this person to have a breakthrough. A breakthrough. They seen the risk. See, the risk that this person was taking, for real, it wasn't adding up for them. It wasn't adding up. And this person was at a loss. Five of Cups. I'm telling you. They was doing magician work to betray another. They was teaming up with other people. Could have been teaming up with this King of Pentacles. To do some bullshit against somebody. You know? But now, whoever they was teaming up, they feel defeated because this Queen of Wands like, nah, I ain't doing that shit no more. I ain't doing that. And that way to step up. This person they surrendered this. Because whatever these people was teaming up and doing together, it could even be an extra person. But I know it's this King of Pentacles and a Queen of Wands, right? It could be an extra person. But this person is surrendering this hate. You know what I'm saying? These people was trying to cause somebody else's illness. These people was trying to cause people to be deeply unhappy, for them not to have nothing, so people don't expand. And they was getting creative with it, right? Trying to have control and cause difficulty in people's lives. And this person was doing this. This person could even been doing this to people that they might experience some type of loss or death or something because of the risk that they was taking. Or they could have got scared about, you know, them maybe having to experience some type of loss or death or something. Yeah. So they wanted to lay to rest trying to block, you know, somebody out. Yeah, because, okay, it could be an extra person here. And they realizing this person is crazy. And they just had a vendetta against somebody trying to hurt somebody. I'm telling you, it could have been two men and a woman that was teaming up doing something to somebody. But they realized that one of these men They just had a vendetta against whoever they was doing something to. I don't know if these three people was attacking another man or if these three people was attacking another woman. I'm not sure of that, but these people definitely was, and somebody could even want to apologize. Somebody could even want to apologize for it. Look, and then after I shuffle, somebody want to apologize for attacking somebody. Somebody want to call somebody and apologize. They could want to do it secretly. They could want to sneak and do it. This person could be blocked, though. Like, this person may not have no means of getting in touch with this person. These people could have been trying to block. Okay, so what these people could be sorry for is that these people was attacking a chosen one, right? A chosen one. Could have been a high priestess. And for me to say, oh, this is why I be fussing. Could be me. But these people would attack a high priestess, a chosen one, right? And it ain't just necessarily only got to be about myself. You know, there's other high priestesses. There's also other people who you may not be a high priestess, but you are connected to a higher power. And people could have been doing, you know, stuff to you. So take, you know, the message as it resonates with you. But these people was trying to block this person's intuition here and lay them to rest. And wanting them to face some sort of embarrassment and lack thereof, you know, illnesses, deep unhappiness, didn't want them to expand, wanted them to walk away from their faith, wanted them to walk away from their faith, their creativity, you know, given spiritual guidance. See, these people was trying to cause constant towers in somebody's life, but they didn't give up. It didn't stop this person. What these people was doing for a long time. But maybe because of what this individual spoke or what these individuals heard, they are now wanting to change. One of these people may not want to, but for the ones that do want to change, they leaving this other person out in the cold. They leaving this man out in the cold. Somebody has been working hard towards a higher form of commitment here. We do have the Wheel of Fortune, but somebody could be dissatisfied and discontent here. Somebody also feel like, you know, they missed the opportunity to have a higher form of commitment with the divine. But somebody was working hard and manifesting in another commitment here that could have brought them some sort of karma. this person regrets that. Somebody could be in some type of partnership where, you know, they dissatisfied and they're juggling, you know. These people could be juggling other people, you know, money, finances, stuff could be tied up here. And somebody could want to escape what they have built with another. Somebody could want to escape it, but somebody didn't listen to spiritual guidance. Somebody was spiritually guided not to get in this partnership, but this is what they wanted to work hard towards. And it's their karma, tower. This person, was in denial. Something could have been revealed. Some secrets could have been revealed, and this person wanted to try to block them out, and they still decided to date somebody. So this Queen of Wands could have, some secrets could have been revealed about a emperor, right? But this Queen of Wands was still trying to date or mess with this person. But it's a pregnancy right here. It's a pregnancy right here. This person thought that they would have success with the devil. They thought that they would have success with the devil, and it's just like, no. This person could be an Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, Cancer, or a Capricorn. Yeah, they thought they was gonna get some type of victory here, but no. They could have realized that it was some type of trap here. These people had a they could have realized it was some type of trap. These people was having sex. But this person has some sort of breakthrough, though. Because even looking here, looking at these cards, it don't really look too colorful. It look kind of like dark gray. Like these people that teamed up together. Judgment, though. These people under judgment, but there are some people who teamed up together to go against another who wants forgiveness, though. You know, I don't know what's gonna occur. I do see karma out here, though. These people is getting karma for the manipulation and the magician work that they did, though. The ultimate betrayal that they did when they teamed up together to go against another. They still gonna reap what they sown, but somebody, you know, is taking action and steps. You know what I'm saying? Taking action and steps. Let's see what they was doing, though. Hold on, where that one deck at? The signs we have out here is Scorpio, Capricorn, Taurus, Virgo. They got that highly aspected in their chart. Gemini, Aries, Taurus. them the signs that are out here so far. But it is a lot of suffering, a lot of backstabbing, sneaky, underhandedness, suffering, backstabbing. It is towers. It is towers. It is karma. Because there was a lot of hate here. And look, and then just even looking at this, how it's all right here in a row right here. These people was doing this shit for a long ass time. Now they surrendering it and walking away from it. These people was messing with spirits. These people was messing with spirits. These people was doing seduction and sex magic. Seduction, sex magic, manipulation. Because with this seduction and sex magic, these people was trying to put individuals in trances, lure them to them, doing magic on people for people to have sex with them. Also just put in that lustful magic and energy on other people. And then this is dangerous too, because this can cause rape. Because it could cause people to want somebody so bad that they're willing to draw blood without no mercy. So these is what these people was doing here to other individuals. This is what they was teaming up doing and messing with. Yep, they was trying to tie people to grief. Wanted people to feel like nothing. Wanted people to constantly mourn. Wanted people to be lost in illusions and shit. These people was also visiting a graveyard, doing graveyard magic and shit. Oh, these people was busy. These people was doing death magic too. So, okay. With them losses, you know that these people experienced. These people experienced people dying around them because of what they did. It's some spirits in the graveyard because of what these people bent up to do. They was doing roots. These people was putting roots on people. What else they was doing? Yeah, they was uncaging different spirits and shit. They was also messing with somebody's womb. Somebody was also doing womb magic, doing roots on somebody's womb. Confirmation? Yeah. Mm-mm. The coming of winter. These people was really trying to make somebody, you know, like wintertime, scarce, things die. This is what these people was trying to do in people's life here. These people was greeting the darkness, messing with the darkness. Yeah, these people was trying to cut people deep with the darkness, with some dark shit. Damn. So these people could want forgiveness because of the karma that they gonna receive in the towers. I'm gonna see if it's now I gotta check and see if it's genuine. But whoever that Queen of Wands is, they like shit. Yeah, these people was trying to transform things here. Whoever that Queen of Wands is, like, oh hell nah. For real, yeah, these people was doing spells and potions, being mischievous, on people ass with this shit. They was on people ass. It could have been up to even 3 to 4 people. I'm telling y'all. Yeah, but like whoever they was doing this against, their elders will sweep that shit away. Like, get that shit out of here. Get that shit out of here. Because these people have somebody on their altar. There's, I mean, get that shit out of here. Somebody was being protected that these people was doing that too. That's why they want forgiveness. Yeah, when these people tried to kill somebody and was doing this graveyard magic, you want to know what they did? Remember when I said they was being protected? They could have been being protected by Yahweh here. And the divine was sweeping that shit away, right? So look, instead of this person dying, all they did was have a death and a rebirth. They rose from the ashes like the phoenix. Yeah, this person, whoever this was, they did this on somebody sacred here. But the divine filled their emptiness. These people was doing rituals on this person's harvest too. Messing around in the underworld, messing around in shit that they shouldn't be fucking around with. So maybe these people like, oh shit. Yeah, these people was being ferocious. Wolves. And maybe they like, oh shit, because that shit gonna come back on their ass. So that's probably why they like, damn. Damn. They must have been doing a lot. But yeah, this stuff got swept away. We got the broom. Yeah, see them altars and them crystalline herbs that they was fucking with, and what was it? Yeah, because they ass ain't about to heal. They ain't gonna have no healing. I don't know what the hell these people did, but this shit in reverse. All of the shit that they was messing with right here. Something got tossed upside down. You know what? Maybe these people was alerted. Yeah, this witch upside down. They're messing with ancient ancestors. These people ain't got no luck. That candle magic ain't worked. I'm trying to silence somebody ain't worked. They protection gone. Somebody was trying to mirror somebody. All this shit in reverse. The harvest, the rituals. I'm telling you. Because somebody intuition is on a beam. Somebody intuition is on fire. And they didn't. Ooh, look. The witch in reverse. They're messing with ancient ancestors in reverse. They luck in reverse. Yeah, because they couldn't hunt somebody. The candle magic in reverse. Them trying to silence somebody because they ain't shutting up. That shit in reverse. These people protection. These three people that was doing shit. And they thought they was protected doing this shit together. Protection in reverse. They ain't got that. These people was trying to reflect somebody else. That question. So these people could have been trying to reflect who they was trying to attack. That shit in reverse. Whatever they was whipping up in the pot. That shit in reverse. Their motherfucking harvest, their harvests and milk and honey is in reverse. Them damn rituals that they was doing, that shit in reverse. I'm telling you. Something, I'm telling you, somebody intuition with this 23 to this 32 with this mirror effect. Somebody intuition knows what awaited these people. Look, be wary of the things you believe to see with eyes wide shut, for they are mirrors of the mad and truths only spoken with a bleeding tongue. These people know for a fact. First, these people with eyes were shut to somebody's intuition and what they knew. These people's eyes was wide shut and they didn't believe it. So they may have continued on with this shit. They thought somebody was mad. They thought somebody was crazy. Yeah, they ain't thinking that shit no more. That shit in reverse. Whoa. I wonder what happened. Whoa, 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 whoa. Somebody could have tried to do some type of traveling to sacrifice somebody divine. There's some type of enlightenment here. Yeah, the Queen of Pentacles just flew out. Queen of Pentacles, Queen of Wands, Queen of Cups. Because now the deck in reverse. The deck in reverse. Some type of karmic soulmate here. These karmics was working together. I'm telling you, teaming up, working together. All of this shit is in reverse. These people didn't get whatever sacrifice they was trying to get. They didn't make somebody stuck like they wanted to make them stuck. These bitches was ruthless. I'm telling you. Ace of Cups in reverse. Eight of Swords in reverse. Page of Pentacles in reverse. King of Cups to the Hermit in reverse. All this shit is in reverse. Judgment Tower, all of it. Something happened with these people. Because these, what happened was, oh, I see. What happened was all of these people that band up together, they was trying to cause instability to a temperance angel. And they all got fucked up or gonna get fucked up. Mm-hmm. I'm telling you, these people in fear. These people fear death, but they didn't mind trying to give it to somebody else. Oh, they tripping. It's a Scorpio feminine. It could be a Scorpio feminine, a Sag, an Aries Leo Sag, or a Capricorn Taurus Virgo. I'm telling you, in a Gemini. Now they want to walk away from that spiritual shit that they was manifesting. Confirmation because of these towers. Oh, these people. Ooh, the Judgment to the Two of Swords. Their forgiveness might be blocked. I'm telling you, because somebody holds some divine power for real. Ace of Swords. It's some type of truth and clarity. These people, for them to get forgiveness, it might even be blocked. The answer might be no. These people did too much. And then the only reason why they probably like, oh, now is because look at all this shit in reverse. When they was already told, hey, I remember that video with just went with the video that just went across my mind. Remember that video when that dude was lighting that firecracker and he was in that wheelchair and they could say, put These people was getting warm before that shit started exploding and shit. And they ain't want to take heed to the warning before the tower started hitting or will hit. They was told to put it in reverse to stop doing that shit. Put it in reverse, Terry. I'm gonna find that video and put it. Now they so close to the now they so close to the, you know, the lightning striking and shit in the kaboom and the towers and all of that shit. Now they trying to back up. Oh no. I still don't know who they was attacking. You only came out here as the Ace of Cups to the Temperance. That's what you came out here as. Yeah, so okay, now I'm seeing it too. These people was working together, working really hard in this coven. This was their partnership that these people had in the damn coven. And these people that was all teamed up in this group doing this bullshit, whether they thought they was in a coven or not. Karma. Karma. Judgment. Shit exploding. You know? Somebody could be trying to turn over a new leaf, but it's probably too late. Let's see. Because it looked like forgiveness is blocked. You know what? I should pull out. Nope, I ain't pulling out nothing else. Is forgiveness blocked for these people? Could these people redeem themselves and get forgiveness? Oh no. Nope. It's over for these people. Damn. See, I was excited and shit. Like, yeah. These people can't. It's over. So these people have to face their karma, and the towers is gonna come in their lives. Yeah, and they scared of it because some of these people might die because, or people around them might die, or things that they love might die because these people was doing death magic and rituals and shit. Yeah, see, these people ain't get the sacrifice that they wanted to get. Oh, it's too late. It's too late for these people. I was excited too, like, oh, they turned over a new leaf. Look at this. It's too late though. They try to make these steps to turn over a new leaf, but it's too late. All these people who banded up together, so this coven is done. These people that was doing this magic and stuff, and in this coven, it's over with. Yep. Dang, it's a little too late though. So these people was already getting warned by another's intuition to stop doing what they was doing. Yeah, and they was being arrogant, like, I'm gonna keep doing that shit. These people was being arrogant, like, I'm gonna keep doing that shit. Fuck what they talking about. So these people was attacking an angelic being that was divinely protected. And they gotta pay the ticket. Whatever that ticket may be. I know I'm listening. And then for me to say that, I know I was probably, I know I probably sent out some warning messages to stop. Did I send out some warning messages for these people to stop doing whatever this was? Yeah, I know I did. Probably along with many others, huh? Yeah, that's what I was picking up. Like, me and other people told these people to stop. They ain't want to listen. So, all of this stuff that's about to happen with these people and this damn little coven that they had going on, doing all of that candle magic, visiting them graveyards, digging up graveyard dirt and casting death spells and messing with people's health and messing with people's wound and doing all of this shit. Ooh, that shit on its way back quick. I seen the Eight of Wands too before I put the deck down. That shit is on its way back to y'all motherfuckers. Y'all should learn to listen. People should just learn to listen. But be wanting to be hard asses. So hard head, make a soft ass. Cause what just ran across my mind is like people they be thinking like, even for what I do, like motherfuckers really be trying to help people. You know what I'm saying? Really just trying to help people. Because the divine ain't gotta do this. The divine ain't gotta let us know, like, hey, that's some bull crap that you're doing, son. That's some bull crap that you're doing, daughter. He's gonna get hot for you. That's a blessing, man. That is a blessing because we all gonna do stuff. Like, I have done stuff. Like, I have shared with y'all a time where I was doing something, right? I was doing something. And right after I did it, I'm telling you, I felt convicted, you know, just within myself, right? I felt that conviction. And I'm telling you, I had ended up getting a sign right after I felt that shit because I knew I shouldn't have been doing that shit. And the message was, the next time your ass do some shit, you do some shit like that, your ass gonna get embarrassed. I'm gonna embarrass your ass. And I know that was not coming from none other than the divine because it is consequences, cause and effect to what you do. Yeah, we say karma and all of that. I just use certain words because it is what, you know, y'all would understand and get. But man, y'all don't understand. That shit be a blessing. And y'all be trying to look at it as something else, like it's a fucking challenge or something. Man, ain't nobody trying to challenge shit. Like, the divine comes to save you from yourself. Because we all need saving from ourselves because we are all our own biggest enemy. And it is true. Even with all that I've been through, even a whole lot of unfortunate events where sometimes I didn't do it to myself, but I still understood, you know, my part, and I still got to see and gain an understanding about what I had to go through. You know what I'm saying? Like, and I still seen that, dang. Even though since I've been younger, a lot of things have occurred that was unfortunate, that was out of my control, I still realize that, dang, Yana is her own biggest enemy. It's what's within me and things within me that the divine, you know, had to cut off and cut out, help me, save me from. But a group of people in trouble. A group of people is in trouble. It's the song that ran across my mind. Hold on, y'all, while I get these grateful heart messages. I'm about to play this confirmation. And you know what? I just want to pause this real quick. Y'all know y'all like, she talking. But listen. It wouldn't, and then if this divine being would have died, what they would have been apologizing to? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, man, if these people wasn't divinely protected that they was trying to mess up, what would they be apologizing to?
I turn around and say,
listen to Timberlake apologize. That could have some extra messages in there for you. So we have here, I praise you, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Wonderful are your works. My soul knows it very well. Yahshua, goodness and unfailing love will pursue me all the days of my life. A state of mind that sees Yahweh in everything is evidence of growth and grace and a thankful heart. Yahshua has done amazing things for us. What a joy. Thank Yahweh for his gift that is too wonderful for words. I'm telling y'all, what I say, this stuff be just telling you, aligning right on up. Aligning right on up. I thank and praise you, Yahweh, for you have given me wisdom and strength. I will lift up my eyes to the hills from whence comes my help. My help comes from Yahshua. Yahweh's blessings are as wide and as deep as the ocean. So, Yahweh done brought a coven down. Yeah, they was messing with a divine being, but, you know, that's that divine power. And the Most High Yahweh, Elohim Yahshua, they brought that thing down and dismantled that thing. So, the divine do be also, see, that's beautiful, too. And that's what I was just praying, and I just had read this, too. Because the divine has been displaying his power amongst the people, and people ain't been paying attention. I've been hearing a lot of things of people saying, and they use Jesus, Yahshua. But they say Jesus coming back, y'all, like Yahweh left or something. He never left. Always been there and always been omnipresent. He never left his creation. But again, I hope you all got a message from this read that'll help y'all along y'all journey. Know that Yahweh loves you. Please like, share, and subscribe. And I will see you all later. Peace.